Hello, this is Domenico with Easynomics, and we're going to continue with elasticity. We'll be looking at a predominantly inelastic demand curve and what happens when we raise or lower price. And to illustrate this example, we could look at Martin Shkreli, owner of a pharmaceutical company who came into the popular press, gained a lot of attention as a result of his company acquiring a drug by the name of Daraprim and increasing its price from $13.50 a pill to $750 overnight. This attracted a lot of bad publicity, and you know, this is something that you can look into if you're curious. This particular drug, Daraprim, is used as treatment with people with HIV/AIDS. It was previously used for people suffering from malaria, but it's now currently used for people suffering from HIV/AIDS. All right, so this is a necessity for people afflicted by this immunity deficiency virus. This drug is a necessity for them. And we can see that pharmaceutical companies are in a position to raise price significantly because of the necessity for their products. So what would this look like? Well, we can assume that in order for Martin Shkreli to raise price by that amount, him and his team priority calculated to a degree the inelasticity of the demand curve, which would allow them to raise price by such a significant amount. So let's go ahead and illustrate what the initial price would have been in theory. So they would have acquired that drug. That drug was priced at $13.50 a pill. So here we are at P1, quantity of demand at Q1, and we're assuming a price of $13.50, okay, for P1. Price times quantity, we don't know what the quantity is. We'll assume perhaps 100,000 consumers. And that would generate the total revenue for this area. But then he raises price by 5,455.56%. All right, that's a 56 fold increase in the price. So it went up from P1 to, let's say, P2, significant increase. Okay. Now, yes, in this demand curve, we see that there's a fall in the quantity of demand, but the change in price is significantly greater than that loss. So in theory, the firm should be increasing their total revenue. So price going from P1 to P2, quantity demand falling from Q1 to Q2. Okay, so we're moving along the demand curve from point A to point B. Now, for price elasticity of demand, you're going to have to calculate percent changes. So the formula, again, is PED equals the percent change in quantity demanded divided by the percent change in price. And percent change is equal to the final value minus the initial value divided by the initial times 100. So let's use the values that we have from this article. We're going to make up the quantity because we don't know what the quantity is. So it went from $13.50 to $750 a pill. And the quantity, we'll assume perhaps it was starting off at 100,000 units consumed, let's say, per year, and it fell to 90,000. Okay. So PED would be calculated as so. So the percent change in quantity demand, the final value is 90,000 minus the initial value divided by the initial value, all of this, then times 100. In addition, this would be divided by the change in price. So the change in price, final being 750, the final value being 750 minus the initial value of 1350 divided by the initial value of 1350 times 100. Okay. So on a paper exam for the IB, you would be given data, data for this point, this price, and you'd have to calculate the elasticity of the demand curve. So when you work this out, you'll see that here there's a negative 10% decrease. And that's going to be divided by a 5,455.56% increase in price, right? So the quantity demanded is falling, but the price is rising. And that gives us an inelastic demand curve that's approximately 0.0018. So PED, right, PED for this drug when calculated is equal to 0.0018. So it's less than one, it's inelastic. What does that mean? So 0.0018 over one. So essentially for every 1% increase in price, the quantity demanded only falls by 0.0018. So very, very negligible fall in quantity as a raised price. So that explains how this firm was able to get away with such a significant increase in price and still increase their total revenue while experiencing a 10% decrease in the quantity of consumption. So seeing this, you can see why it is important for governments to intervene and regulate this market, because it's firms that have this degree of market power where they're facing an inelastic demand curve because the product is a necessity for the consumer, can get away with such significant increases in price. So governments will need to regulate, intervene on the behalf of society to protect these consumers from being exploited by a firm with this level of market power. Okay, so let's make some initial notes here, and then we're going to analyze this as we would for a paper exam for the IB. Okay. So we've calculated that the demand curve, D1, is very inelastic, right? It's a very inelastic demand curve. Its PED value is less than 1, which means that the percent change in price is going to be greater than the percent change in quantity demanded. Thus, as the firm raises price, their total revenue is going to increase. Okay, so any firm that has an inelastic demand curve can get away with raising price to increase total revenue because the percent change in price is greater than the percent change in quantity demanded, right? That's the important point of this model. So let's go ahead and illustrate this. As can be seen, we have a graph. Let's say we'll call it graph A, illustrating the market for a pharmaceutical drug, Daraprim. And Daraprim has a very inelastic demand curve. It is a necessity, in this case, for people afflicted with HIV/AIDS. And as a result of this necessity, the demand curve is a very steep slope. The quantity is being measured on the x-axis, and the price of this drug is being measured on the y-axis. And we can see that this firm is pricing initially at P1, with the quantity of demand at Q1, which is at point A, and thus their total revenue is areas A plus B. Okay, so at a price of P1, the total revenue is equal to areas A plus B. But then the firm decides to raise price from P1 to P2, and according to the law of demand, the quantity demand falls from Q1 to Q2. That's a movement along the demand curve from point A to point B. We see that the change in price is greater than the decrease in quantity. The percent change in price being greater than the percent change in quantity demanded should lead to an increase in total revenue as a result of a change, an increase in price. So in this case, when they raise price from P1 to P2, total revenue is now equal to areas C plus A. And because area C is greater than the area A, this firm has increased their total revenue. So thus total revenue is greater than total revenue 2 is greater than total revenue 1. Okay, so total revenue 1 being areas A plus B, and total revenue 2 being area C plus A, because area C is greater than A, total revenue 2 is greater than total revenue 1. Right? Thus, illustrating how along an inelastic demand curve, an increase in price leads to an increase in total revenue, and vice versa. If the firm was to lower price from P2 to P1, quantity demand would increase, but they would experience a decrease in total revenue. All right, so if we were to analyze that, the firm pricing at P2, quantity demanded at Q2 at point B, total revenue equal to area C plus A, then they lower price from P2 to P1, increasing quantity demanded from Q2 to Q1. Thus, total revenue at P1 times Q1 being equal to areas A plus B is less than the previous total revenue of area C plus A, because area B is less than area C. So the firm has lost area C just to gain area B, thus their total revenue would be decreasing. All right, and that's it. I will provide notes in the information section of this YouTube video, just providing an outline of how to analyze this graph if you were to raise or to lower price and its impact on total revenue. And that's it. If you have any questions, feel free to comment, and don't forget to subscribe or to like.